Hello, this is Lawrence Jordan from Crosstalk Radio Ministries, and I have to address an issue with some wolves and sheep's clothing that continue to slander not only myself, but many other godly Watchmen on the Wall ministries that are on Facebook, on YouTube, and so many other ways that God is using in powerful ways in these last days. Men that we all love and respect, like Mark Roy and Todd Tomsella, Angelo Sanchez, there's many of them that these guys are purposely trying to cause divisions and get people to turn against them. And many of us have had our run-ins with Mr. Larry Davenport and Patricia Hageman, my ex-radio partner from WOW Radio, Watchmen on the Wall. These are vile people that post complete lies. They just do nothing but slander radio shows all the time. They don't edify, they don't build the body, they don't teach and preach and reach. All they do is lie, slander, and they stalk your Facebook accounts to try to find slander on you. That's all they do. So I'm doing a video now to expose them. Turning the camera around. This is a slander blog that Miss Patricia and Larry Davenport have on their WTVO radio. By the way, they've changed the name of it several times. They've ruined their name so much. Nobody wants anything to do with WTVO or Watchmen on the Wall. These guys have done such evil to everybody that nobody wants anything to do with them. We've all seen their fruit. Several of my 3,500 friends on Facebook have watched these people try to destroy me. They've watched them make pictures of my dad going up in a tornado, photoshopped, on a slander blog. They seen the picture of my dog making fun of him that he died. They found a picture of a dead yellow lab and stuck it on that slander blog, making fun of him. Guys, this is not the fruit of a man of God or a woman of God. That spirit is murder. Now, this is Patricia here. My ex-radio partner turned against me three times. This time it's a doozy. She's been turned over by the Lord, by the way, and several of us elders in Christ. We had to rebuke them openly over a year ago. She's mocking me here. The Never-Ending Adventures of Man Elder. Slander blog. Captain Man Elder. This was a picture that her husband generously made out of the kindness of his heart as kind of a little logo joke for me. You know, it was funny. At the time, it was Captain Repento that was supposed to be. She doctored it up to make it look evil. Then she puts the money here. She thinks I'm all about money. I'm one of the poorest preachers out there. Angelo struggles. I struggle. Brother Don struggles. We all struggle. Todd struggles. Guys, the true Watchmen on the Wall are not being supported by the body because people are giving all their money to Joel Osteen and J.D. Snakes or Fakes or whatever his name is and Kenneth Copeland. And, you know, he's a billionaire. I don't even want to go there in the prosperity gospel. You guys all know you're smart enough in Jesus that these are not correct gospel preachers. They are false preachers of the devil. All they're doing is stealing money. All we're trying to do is get, we're asking the body of Christ to help with the cost of getting radio, YouTube, and all of the ministry cost out there. Get the word out. Preach the word in season and out of season. Rebuke and correct with all long suffering. That's what we're doing. Our hearts are right. Our motives are right. We don't want money because all it does is mess people up anyway. We've watched and seen on TV what it's done to these people. Let me tip my screen here a bit. So she goes on here and she's stalking my Facebook account. She's got a fake one. I got her blocked. She comes on here, copies and pastes everything I post on here, asking the body of Christ for help to help keep Crosstalk on the air and the ministry going. It's helped a lot of people, lots of people. There's fruit. You guys all seen it. 3,500 of my friends. No matter what this babbling woman says, you all see it. And you know. And you comment and you tell me. And you tell me to keep going. And I praise God for you, dear saints. Thank you so much for your encouragement. Because there's times that the cross gets heavy on my back. The slander gets ridiculous. The attacks. And these are so-called brothers and sisters doing this, but they're not. And we can see by the accuser of the brethren, demon spirits that are in these people. This is not of God. Now, this has been going on for months. You can see the dates. It's all over here. I posted this link on my Facebook wall so everybody can take a look at it. This is Patricia mocking me, her old radio partner. And she's making fun of your comments, by the way. Tells me to get a job. When I do try to work for word constantly, you guys know that. I even work side jobs here in the RV park. I do. And I work in the park for rent. So I'm not a lazy man like this woman accuses me. She's angry. She wants revenge. And she's doing everything she can to destroy me in my name. Look at this. This is where one time I was asking the body for help. She's mocking me here and accusing me falsely. Let's go on down to the bottom here where she started this. She's mocking Tom Sella right now too. Safeguard Your Soul Ministries. He's a godly man. He's trying to help warn the body of Christ too. Very effective. Mark Roy and Todd, myself, Angelo, all of us are effectively warning the body of Christ scripturally to watch out for false teachers and wolves and apostasy in these last days. We do it because we love you, not because we're going to get rich. If you tell the truth, you're not going to get rich. We're not in it for the money. Patricia, Davenport, get a clue. We're not in it for the money. If we were in it for the money, we'd tell lies. We'd be billionaires like Joel Osteen. Get a clue and judge righteously. Foolish ones. The truth preachers have always struggled. They have always had hardships. They have always had persecution. They've always had, sometimes sleeplessness, fastings, and hungry. Read the New Testament. You'll see what the apostles in the early church went through. She's mocking David O'Connor, by the way, here too. David O'Connor's been my friend for many years. He's seen through their lies and ran away from them too. So she's mocked me for months. Copy and paste. What is she doing? Why is she leaving me alone? Why does she continue to go onto my Facebook wall bothering me? She don't want to let it go. It's been a year. It's been a year and she won't shut up. She continues to spy with a fake account. See? Look at this. Well, I guess it's time for the month again for man elder Jordan. Posted 4/6/2015. I was asking the body for help. I couldn't pay for my crosstalk blog talk. I was asking for a little help. Praise God, many of you brothers and sisters that know the fruit of crosstalk have helped. Thank you and praise God. We're laboring together for the ministry of Jesus Christ and the kingdom of God. And that's the whole reason. That's the only reason. I am not going to get rich and I don't want to be rich. I'm rich in Christ. I know Jesus Christ. I know the truth, guys, and I've been set free. That's the best riches in the entire universe. I don't want to live for this planet and for my flesh. I don't want to live for planes, trains, and automobiles. I want to live for Jesus Christ. And that means self-denial and cross-bearing. This is what they're accusing me of. Like I'm one of those prosperity gospels? Come on! You have heard me preach on crosstalk on these wolves of Joel Osteen and Rick Joyner, Bill Johnson, Kenneth Copeland, you know, all of them. TJ Snakes. All of them, you know, Dollar, all of these preachers are nothing but a bunch of con artists, criminals, stealing money. And Christians are giving billions of dollars every year to them. They're living luxury lifestyles, and they're not denying themselves and picking up the cross. Okay, let me get down here. I'm just getting too much blanks. Patricia doesn't know how to copy and paste, obviously, during her slander. I always had her teach her stuff when we were together as partners. Okay. Now she's making fun of Don Kontz here. During the Watchman Warning intro, Mr. Jordan, what does that say? Impersonated his buddy Don Kontz. Oh, that's stupid. Don Kontz. See, now they're always about trying to set up people's IP address. This is what they love to do. Yeah. Okay, let's get down here. Where she's slandering me, where this whole blog started. This is where she's actually making fun of me when I was at her house with her family during a Shabbat Sabbath service. And her oldest son asked me to teach him how I practiced witchcraft when I was a New Ager Wiccan. And I said, I will not teach you that. I will only tell you to read your Bible and get to know Jesus Christ. These two sons play on the computer all day Warcraft. You tell me that's a house in order with a minister, a woman minister? Hello. And they're asking me how to practice witchcraft. She's mocking that I actually did the right thing and told her sons, I'm not going to tell you how to do the dark arts and black magic. I'm going to tell you how to get right with God and repent and live holy and walk with Jesus Christ, the way, the truth, and the life. She's making fun of me. She's been making fun of me. And I did the right thing, and she's made fun of me ever since. So let's go down here to where all of you can look at this later on. Right here, the radio show that they were doing live slandering me. I had just finished a radio program with Jason Schofield, the first frontline radio with Crosstalk. And we were on Skype. Somebody messaged me, I'm not going to tell who their name is, for their privacy reasons, and told me I was being slandered on WTVO after I had left them. They were saying I was demon-possessed, I wasn't saved, I was a homo, and I was still a witch. And I never renounced crystals, tarot cards, and the New Age stuff. I've been walking with Jesus Christ for 30 years. Either I'm a bold-faced liar, or I'm the best bold-faced liar, cross-preaching, holiness preacher out there. Because you can't have darkness and light, you moron, Larry Davenport, accusing me of being demon-possessed. So, they did this radio show. I found out about it. I went in there to the chat room to rebuke them. Well, I was rebuking boldly. Yes, I had righteous anger, and I was letting them have it all through this conversation. They got it all copied and pasted here. Yep, I was pretty bold in what I said. Some guy on the Tiny Chat software came in there, which Tiny Chat is used for sexual people having sex. When you log into Tiny Chat, there was a whole bunch of people lined up half naked. Women were showing their breasts naked. We complained to Larry. He said, why are we using Tiny Chat if it's pornographic filth? Well, I was preaching, or I was rebuking Larry Davenport and Patricia for what they were accusing me of. Some guy came in, and according to the eyewitness, Lee Ann Clover seen a brown-skinned Mexican guy show his sexual organs on a camera. I didn't even see it. But I guess it's because I probably got kicked out and then I went back in after that happened. I don't know. It doesn't matter. It was not me. I would never do such a stupid thing in the first place. They blamed me for that, tried to frame me and said that that was me. They have no evidence. All they're trying to do is frame my IP address. But they don't have any actually video. Davenport's got this on YouTube right here. I'm actually pointing to it. See this right here? This is the video of Davenport on YouTube slandering me that I got caught showing my sexual parts to 21 people in a chat room. It's been there for a year. He's never taken it down. He's never apologized. Even Mark Faber, we've somewhat kind of reconciled, said that I didn't do it. And he told Davenport, I don't think that was Lawrence that did that. Did Davenport take it down? No. So it's still up. This is their filth. They're continuing to slander me. Daily, she's posting on here. She's had three strokes as a sign from God to stop it. Right after a slander show they did against me, 1 hour after God showed me, she was punished. Three strokes, three brain aneurysms as a sign from God. Knock it off. Leave my servants alone and stop slandering them. Leanne Clover and I, which Leanne Clover was a follower of Patricia and Davenport's, she's seen for herself what they were doing. She knew, and she caught them. John Evans caught them, and several other people caught them, lying and slandering and making stories up. And she warned them to stop, and then Larry Davenport and Patricia turned on Leanne Clover and John Evans and several other people that were followers of WTVO and started to slander and attack them and threaten them. This is the fruit of Patricia and Larry Davenport and WTVO Radio. And they continue to do this. Okay, so there's that. Now, right here, here's the actual thing right here of Mr. Davenport's YouTube channel. See that right there? Mr. L.T. Davenport. Blog Talk Radio Minister Crosstalk Mr. Jordan exposes the genitals to 21 live people. Right there. That's what he put. This is what. This is the actual one, and YouTube tried to make him take it down. Lawrence Jordan caught red-handed exposing his genitals to 21 people of a live online TV broadcast. Leanne Clover was one of them. She said it was a Mexican. It was not a white boy. I'm white, guys. That wasn't even my sexual manhood on the camera. Nor was it my IP address that turned on a camera because my camera was not turned on. My sister was sitting right in my motorhome with me during this whole process, guys. Hello. I have witnesses. You are a liar, Larry Davenport. A liar and a slanderer, just like you did on the previous blogs. That Jason Arnold caught you hosting the slander blogs on your Agape For You church website. You were slandering on the same domain on GoDaddy, the slander blogs. And Jason Arnold was your radio broadcaster on your own ministry, caught you lying. And that you were doing this in the name of Jesus. And he said, this has got to stop. You're bringing shame on the body of Christ in Jesus' name. He rebuked you openly, caught you, you lied. He screenshotted the evidence of the domain address and matched it to your church website and proved it. You were a caught liar, Mr. Davenport, and this is why you still lie your face off, and your family hits the like buttons and all your buddies that you've got deceived, which is very small audience, believe your lies. But this is you, right here. You're calling me demon-possessed, and I have evil spirits. Look at the face on Davenport.
I'm doing this live recording for a specific person, for a specific purpose. Excuse me, I'm tired. It's after midnight. Of exposing the action in the Watchman's Warning broadcast this evening. We were in the chat room and we were ministering, and there was open rebuke being.
Come on, Davenport, look in the camera so we can see the demons in your eyes.
The chat area three different times. The first time he was banned, and because I believe.
Let's back it up.
Specific purpose that broadcast. I asked Sister Patricia to unban him so that he would be able to hear it and view what was going on.
Let me
expose exactly what Lawrence did. Let me be blunt about what Lawrence Jordan did. He came into the chat room, and because he was in such a rage, and I openly...
And the reason I was in a rage is because they said I was not saved, and I was filled with demons, and I was still practicing witchcraft. Guys, those are some severe charges. So I rebuked Davenport. Did not show my genitals, that liar. So let's go on here and let this man, this devil, hang himself.
Rebuked
with his own
him. He left. He then later came back into the broadcast area, and while we were ministering live, he was broadcasting live video of his private parts. Lawrence Jordan did this. I'm going to prove it. 21 people in the chat room witnessed
what he did. Look at the demons in Davenport's eyes.
Several of them that you may personally know.
You can see the darkness.
Sister Leanne Glover, Sister Cheryl.
Yeah, ask Leanne Glover right now. She's left WTVO, and she knows that wasn't me. She knows it. We've talked over and over since all this happened, and she knows that it was a setup by Larry Davenport. You ask her herself. She's on Facebook. Ask John Evans. Ask all the other ones that were in that time, and they have caught Mr. Davenport. This is a frame-up, a setup, a false witness, a lying report. Proverbs chapter 6, six things the Lord hates, a lying tongue, a hands that send innocent blood, and those who sow seeds of discord amongst the brethren. How about a false witness? This is a false witness right here. This man is trying to peg my IP address on a smartphone that's not even compatible with Tiny Chat. So he's a bold-faced liar. I rebuke you in the name of Jesus, Mr. Davenport. The Lord binds you and rebuke you.
Sister Kelly Holder, Brother John Evans, Sister Patricia Hageman, many of these people that you very likely know, they can...
Yeah, right there. That's all I'm going to play because I don't have much time on my YouTube thing here. So that's Mr. Davenport right there telling me, everybody, that I exposed myself. You 3,500 of my friends on Facebook know I would never do such a stupid thing. I'm a man of integrity filled with the Holy Spirit. Here's Mr. Devilport's picture right here. Right here. This is the devil right there. Here's his Facebook account. This man, all of the people, only people that follow him is his family members and people who are deceived and have no discernment. And all he does is slander. See, this beloved saint, he just attacked my Facebook wall. I rebuked and blocked, banned. Diane's all a buddy of Miss Jezebel Patricia. Here's Patricia's Facebook wall right now. She's slandering me right here. She says she's a 62-year-old woman with the mind of a 30-year-old. Really? That's a matter of opinion. The wisdom, let me try to get this over, the wisdom of a 90-year-old and a follower of Messiah Yeshua. She's still Hebrew Roots Movement, guys. Don't let her fool you. I could care less what anybody thinks of me or says about me. And Diane, she goes, she speaks the truth or whatever. She means what she says. Kelly Colder, which turned on me too, says, let's talk, she goes, let's talk sling lies because they are going to, it's hard to read this on the thing. Let me read it this way. It said, let's talk sling lies because they are going to reap what they are sowing, and he wonders why he's not blessed in all his ways. Then she goes on the next comment, well, you must be doing something right for the Lord. Slandering? Slandering God's watchman? Or it wouldn't be sending his little man to attack you again. She's calling me the little man of Satan. Kelly Holder is mocking me and accusing me. He needs to repent. Patricia goes, ha, 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 laugh out loud, little man. They're mocking me. Is this the way a child of God? Here comes Larry Davenport, Mr. Smartmouth. Ha, 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 little man. This is the work of the devil, the accuser of the brethren. This attitude is not of the Holy Spirit or a child of God making fun and calling me a little man. Kelly comes in and got that, huh? Sad but true. Mocking. You go down here. Let's go take a look where she's mocking Todd Tomsella. Let's see here. Let's see if I can find that real quick. It's been a few days. She appears as a godly woman, but she's actually a little monster. And believe me, I would know. I ministered with her. I was in her house twice. I seen the fruit. So did William Thomas. Her house is not in order. She's a slanderer. Here we are. She's slandering Todd Tomsella right here. Says, was just reading someone's post on women preachers. We all know what the scriptures say about that in Timothy and Titus and other places, that, you know, they're allowed to prophesy. They're not allowed to be church leaders. The scriptures say so. How they should just be baby makers, cook and clean. I know Todd. Todd did not say that. And if he did, she's taken out of context to slander him. I'm floored how he twists the scripture to fit his doctrines. I'm floored, Patricia, how you twist the scriptures to be a woman preacher and to soup an authority over men. And you're claiming to be yourself a watchman prophetess over God's people. When I don't see that anywhere in the scriptures, in the New Testament anywhere. It was 12 men apostles and disciples. And it was always men that God chose for leadership, including apostle, prophet, evangelist, pastor, teacher. The scriptures are clear on that. Now she's accusing Todd to trying to sell books for his ministry as a good bill-paying racket. So she's mocking him. Question for Todd Tomsella. Since jailed for not paying child support, that I know of, are you finally doing so to help your ex-wife and deserted with children? You deserted with your children, and it shows have no respect for her. Safeguard your offspring before you try to safeguard other souls. SMH. She's mocking Brother Todd Tomsella, Safeguard Your Ministries. And she will not shut up. This woman's mouth is out of control. Many of my friends have had run-ins with her. She's mean. They tried to correct her. She mouths off to them and blocks them. She doesn't receive correction. Now let's go over here. Let's check out some pictures here. Some pictures. Let's see them attacking me about asking for the body of Christ to help support Crosstalk Ministries. Nothing wrong with that. I'm doing it correctly. I'm doing the right thing. I'm not living high on the hog. There's some ministry cost here. How many of us have always given as a cheerful giver to God's work so that the kingdom of God is expanded? She's trying to accuse me falsely. And look at the hypocrites. This is WTBO Radio's website. This is a screenshot. Larry Davenport has a donate button. PayPal. Look at that. He even takes Visa, MasterCard, Recovery Card, Discovery Card. Hello. Give to their ministry. So the little hypocrites are condemning me, saying that I'm not supposed to, while they're doing it. Could that be a double-minded man unstable? Here's another one of a donate thing. WTVO. Look at that. Radio. Right there. They take Visa, MasterCard. Hello. Help the ministry out. I'm telling you, in itself, there's nothing wrong with this. But to accuse me of being a beggar and all this garbage is ridiculous. And these hypocrites are asking for donations too. This is absolutely wicked. Now let's take a look at Mr. Larry Davenport's wolf posts that he's done to try to destroy me in the past. He calls me a wolf. A wolf among us. He's got this on his blog. When the wolf cries wolf. And so he had posted this to slander me several months ago, actually last year. And he continues to have it on his wall. Now, let's take a look at another thing he posted to try to publicly destroy me. Right after we all broke up, he put this on his Facebook wall, that I ran from Strawberry, Arizona, fled because I had the law after me. I had charges pending against me against the Gila County Sheriff Department. I made a phone call to Detective Karen Bolts to completely debunk this. I asked her, is there any charges against me for breaking restraining order? She goes, Lawrence, there is no charges against you. They are against Charlene Clark. She is a vile liar. She even rebuked me and told me to stop listening to these people. She goes, your friends know who you really are. You know why she said that? Because she listens to Crosstalk Radio. She knew I was a man of integrity. She's not even a Christian, and she knew. I was telling the truth when I was preaching on Crosstalk and being real with people. Very rare to find that. She knew. And Detective Karen Bolts of the Gila County Sheriff's Department, I have a YouTube video where she's actually agreeing with me that Charlene and the rest of them are all liars. She says it with her own mouth, and she told me to sue them for $1 million for defamation of character and damage. So Mr. Davenport put this thing on here, which he got off the slander blog. This is off the slander blog right here that's up on against me right now, that I have the police after me. Charlene Clark made this report. She's a liar, too. And the charges are against her, and you can prove it. It's public record. Call the Gila County Sheriff Department and Payson, Arizona. They will tell you. They know all about this vile woman. They have 600 documents of evidence on how she has just attacked me and stalked me at my job and come to my trailer and everything, harassing me. Made false witness reports and signed people's name to them that didn't even sign them. She has lots of charges against her. She's a vile house church cult. Her and Dan Clark are both wolves in sheep's clothing. The Agape Harvest Church, now called Church of Strawberry, Arizona. False Latter-day Rain, New Apostolic Reformation, NAR. They're part of the fire tunnels, and this outpouring of super apostles is going to take over the planet, Dominion now. You know, I've warned and warned about this. It's all over the internet. We've all been watching this Kundalini stuff. They're part of that. And believe me, they're possessed with them. So many of us have had run-ins with Dan and Charlene Clark, including David O'Connor. Ask him his testimony about what they did to him and his Aussie Disciple Band member. Yeah, from Street Church. Ask David O'Connor. Yep, he'll tell you. So here's what we got. We are exposing here. This is the wickedness of WTVO Radio Patricia and Larry Davenport. And I just posted something on my Facebook with all this evidence, and I'm backing it up with a YouTube video, laying it all on the table. Patricia agreed with Mr. Davenport when she was on the phone with me, Detective Karen Bolts. She knows Detective Karen Bolts' voice. She also knows that was a genuine phone call. Davenport purposely tried to say it was a fake. It was absolutely genuine. And you can call Detective Karen and ask her, did you say those things? She said, yes, I did. That was me. That's my voice on there. It absolutely is. So, Davenport, you lied. Patricia, you lied when you knew the truth. And you actually spoke with Detective Karen Bolts with me in a Skype conversation and on the telephone. In fact, we were both working together to stop the whole slander against us both at that time. And then you turned on me and you joined the very slander blog people that were trying to destroy us both. You are a two-faced, double-minded man and unstable in all your ways. Backstabber. Talk about the Judas spirit of betrayal. You know, I've let you go. I've forgiven you, Patricia. I really have. But you can't let it go, can you? You continue on your blogs to just try to destroy me and Don and Mark and anybody that you can't get to bow down to your Jezebel spirit that you are possessed with. We all see it. We all know it's there. And I had brothers and sisters warn me of it. And now I see it plain as day. The Lord Jesus Christ rebuke you and silence your tongues. The Lord will bring a charge against you. The Lord will correct. Vengeance is the Lord's. He shall repay. So, this is my testimony from Lawrence Jordan of Crosstalk Radios against these slanders that's coming against me. So, pray, saints. Expose them. Mark them. Rebuke them. Go on their walls and rebuke these people and say, I dare you speak against Lawrence Jordan and Mark Roy and Todd Tomsilla and Angelo and any of the other preachers out there that they've come against. Especially Patricia loves to tear after men of God that speak against women preachers biblically. Oh yeah, but they're correct. They're using scripture. It's not their opinions. It's not their feelings. It's not that they're a woman hater. These guys love women. They love sisters in Christ and exhort them. But there's out of orderness when you've got apostle in front of your name, or you've got pastor in front of your name, or watchman prophetess in front of your name, and you're not even in that position because you're not allowed to scripturally to be there. So she's a rebellious person who wants not to follow the scripture in correction. Many of us have gone to her to correct her. Mark Roy, she was calling him names and, you know, he had to block her because she's nuts in the head. She just wants to rule men. That's the spirit of the Jezebel spirit, controlling, manipulating, and trying to be in positions they don't belong in the home, and the over the husband, and over the church, over leadership. This is out of order. So they are exposed, and I'm going on with my ministry. Praise, pray for Crosstalk. Pray for me, brothers and sisters. And there's nothing wrong with supporting the work of the ministry when you see the fruit from Jesus Christ himself. You know it's there. Many of you have told me it's there. Thank you for helping me, Lawrence. We so appreciate you. We're praying for you because you are really being real with people and telling the truth. You're laying down your life as a true disciple. God bless you, dear saints. I love you all in Jesus. Keep fighting the good fight. Please support your watchmen on the wall. All of them. I'm not just talking for me. I'm talking all of them. You know who they are. You hit the amens and the likes on their posts daily. And you are so grateful for the exhortation you get from these dear saints. So God bless you. Let's run the race and endure to the end. Amen. Let's make our Abba Father proud in these last days. Let's walk in holiness. Let's not let these slandering liars try to divide us because we see their fruit. I just showed it to you. Let's not let that happen. God bless you all, and God bless.